If you only want to watch one video about small wind turbines, it should be about this topic. It's about success factor number one. The most important requirement for a small wind turbine for private or commercial use. A location where the wind is strong enough throughout the year. Otherwise, you will regret the installation of the turbine. Your wind turbine will be useless if you do not have a site where the wind is strong enough. I'm Patrick. As a neutral expert and author, my role is to honestly say when a small wind turbine makes sense at all. Not every private property or commercial site is suitable for the installation of a small wind turbine. And after watching the video, you will know how to carry out a site check for your own property. Then you will know whether the wind is strong enough for a small wind turbine. And if you want to receive regular updates on the technology, market, and planning of small wind turbines, then you should subscribe to this channel. The number one success factor for a small wind turbine is a windy location. It can produce significant electricity only in a windy site. It is therefore a question of location and not technology. And it is always a case-by-case decision. Two properties just 200 meters or 200 yards apart can have completely different wind conditions. At the same time, it's by far the biggest mistake made with small wind turbines. Many people neglect the key issue of wind resource at the site. And I'm often contacted by people with questions about small wind turbines. My first question is always, have you checked whether there's strong enough wind on your property? And the answer is often, oh, that's no problem. I have enough wind where I live. Because the trees often sway strongly in the wind, or the house makes a lot of noise in strong winds. I hear statements like this from private homeowners as well as from employees and companies. But my advice, do not just assume that the local wind resource is high. Please make a site check. There are important rules for the use of wind energy you should know. Small wind turbines can be severely affected by obstacles such as trees or buildings blocking the wind. The wind that can be utilized by the wind turbine moves parallel to the Earth's surface. Obstacles such as buildings and trees stop the wind and reduce the energy. Behind the obstacles, there's too little wind for a long distance. This is a crucial difference between wind energy and solar energy. The sun shines on the roof from above and often reaches the solar modules without shading. A tree has to be very close to the house to create shade. Wind, on the other hand, is much more often blocked by obstacles such as trees. In short, the sun comes from above, the wind from the side. This is why there are far more suitable locations for solar installations than for small wind turbines. It is therefore important that there is sufficient distance between the wind turbine and the obstacle. The higher the obstacle, the greater the distance to the wind turbine must be. Assuming the wind is coming from this direction here, the building stops the wind and causes turbulences behind the building. The rotor of the wind turbine cannot convert this wind turbulence into electricity or only insufficiently. The wind energy is too low in this area. You should not install a wind turbine there. As a rule of thumb, the distance between the wind turbine and the obstacle should be 20 times the height of the obstacle. An example, if the house has a height of 10 meters or 30 feet, then the distance between the house and the wind turbine should be 200 meters or 600 feet. Another important wind energy rule, a free flow from the main wind direction is crucial. Therefore, you need to know the main wind direction for the location where the wind turbine will be installed. You can find out the main wind direction in your region via the Global Wind Atlas. It's easy to do with just a few clicks. Go to globalwindatlas.info, set the point approximately at the place where the wind turbine should be installed, select wind power rows, and from the wind rows you can read the main wind direction. In this example, the wind comes from the south-southwest and the south. So, the strong wind flows from the south to the north. A simple rule of thumb can be derived from these basic rules. In a good and windy location, you have a clear view if you're looking to the main wind direction. An example, in this photo you are looking to the main wind direction. There's no obstacle to be seen far and wide. The wind can therefore flow freely. This is an example of a particularly good location where a small wind turbine could be installed. At the exact location where the photo was taken, there is a small wind turbine with an output of 5 kW. You can see the wind turbine here. This time, the photo shows in the main wind direction. It is a small farm in Germany. There will be countless similar locations around the world where you can use the strong main wind. You can also use Google Maps as a tool to check a location and its surroundings. Google Maps is helpful to check the distance between the wind turbine site and an obstacle that could block the main wind. An example. Let's assume we want to install a small wind turbine at this location. The arrow shows the main wind direction. It is south-southwest and south. Looking to the main wind direction, we can see a small forest some distance away with trees that are about 20 meters or 60 feet high. Could this forest weaken the wind energy at the site of the turbine? Let's remember the distance rule. The distance between the wind turbine and the obstacle should be 20 times the height of the obstacle. To find out, we need to know how far away the forest is. We click with the right mouse button and select Measure Distance. We place the second click at the target point. Now we can read the distance. The distance between the wind turbine and the forest is about 500 meters or 1600 feet. And now we apply the distance rule. Height of the trees was 20 meters. Permitted distance is 20 meters times 20, so 400 meters. But the measured distance is 500 meters. So the conclusion is the location is suitable. This is because the measured distance is greater than the permitted distance according to the rule. Please note, this rule of thumb provides a rough guide to the suitability of a location. Anyone investing a lot of money in a small wind turbine should consider a professional site assessment. This could be a wind measurement or an analysis by an engineering office for wind energy. The economics of a wind power project can then be calculated based on this wind data. Now let's look at typical locations that are likely to have good wind resources. Single locations. So this applies to single sites. A single site is typical for many farms. There's often only agricultural land around the farm buildings. The wind can flow freely from all directions. Furthermore, locations on the edge of settlements or on the edge of a forest may also be suitable. Please remember this because it is so important. It must be the edge from which you have a clear view looking to the main wind direction. Locations on a slope or at a height can also be promising. If there are a lot of hills in your area, you should pay attention to this. Such high altitude locations can have particularly good wind conditions because the wind force increases with height. Many people dream of being 100% self-sufficient, to be able to supply themselves completely with energy, so that they are no longer dependent on the public grid. Is that possible? Yes, it is possible if you know the secret of such prepper sites, a location where you can make good use of wind energy and solar energy. Use of wind energy, free flow from the main wind direction, and use of solar energy, one roof or several roofs with a lot of sun. 100% self-sufficiency with energy is primarily a question of location, not technology. You need a property with strong wind and plenty of sun. Of course, there are such locations. The windy locations are obviously not in the city or residential areas, but in the countryside. So my advice, if you want to build a new house or buy a house, always ask yourself, how well can I use solar energy and wind energy in this location? Here we see a typical example. A house in the countryside in an open location. The wind can flow onto the wind turbine rotor from almost all sides undisturbed. This is a small wind turbine with an output of 12 kW in the north of Germany. There are also various roofs on which solar modules can be installed. Of course, a battery storage system is still necessary for self-sufficiency. When I'm out hiking or looking at Google Maps, I always look for locations like this, because properties like this are worth their weight in gold. Which locations are not suitable due to low wind resources? Locations in the middle of settlements. These are locations in the middle of residential areas or commercial areas. Buildings and trees that block the wind from the main wind direction are the main problem. Most valleys are not good locations either, as the wind often blows weakly at the bottom of the valley. Exceptions may be valleys that run along the main wind direction. This must therefore always be checked on a case-by-case basis. Also, in areas with a lot of forest, you have to be careful when checking a site. Here you need a location on the edge of the forest with a clear view facing the main wind direction. The conclusion? The wind supply of a specific location for a small wind turbine is always a case-by-case assessment. This is because the immediate surroundings of the wind turbine locations are decisive. Above all, there must be a free flow of wind from the main wind direction. There will be millions of suitable locations for small wind turbines around the world. Perhaps you can also find a location for yourself where you can use wind and sun so well that you can be self-sufficient all year round. If you have a suitable location for a small wind turbine, then you want to find out about recommended manufacturers. This video here explains what you need to consider when buying a small wind turbine. Thanks for watching and take care.